Acho, was Baker Mayfield a success in Cleveland?
First off, don't give me three sentences of shots.
Everybody!
And then ask me if it was a success, big dog.
Well.
Because you're trying to ask me a biased question. Mm. But yes, Baker Mayfield's career in Cleveland was more than a success. It was truly, I think, as good as it could have gone based on a reality of how it could have gone.
Oh, let's hear it.
I'm going to go places and y'all travel with me. Mm. So when you know you're at a severe deficit, you never try to make up all of the deficit in one attempt.
Yep. That's
I'm going to give y'all a few examples. Some you can relate to, some you may not be able to relate to. Mm-hmm. Track and field. If you are running a relay race, if your first leg gets you way far behind, then the second leg's job isn't truly to make up the major distance, but a second leg. Can you close ground so that my third leg can close ground so that my anchor leg can make up all the ground and catch up? Okay, that didn't work. Let's go bigger picture. Hmm. We've had a bunch of race conversations as of late.
Going.
We know that societally in our country, black people are at a historical disadvantage based upon slavery, amongst other things. Woo. 100, 200, 300 year disadvantage. My objective in this life, I don't know about you, Marcellus, so I will not speak for you, mm-hmm. but my objective is just make up ground for the next generation.
There you
and
go.
Make up ground for the next generation. You, big dog, all kudos to you. Went from Compton to Columbia, now to the hills, to Encino, to everywhere in between.
Stop saying out the city. We're going to tell you the address through there.
1356 Northridge Way. So you made up ground. The objective was never to catch everybody in one generation, but make up ground. In football, as I look at it, one generation is 4 years because that is the duration of a contract. Mm. 4 years.
Okay.
Baker Mayfield made up a whole lot of ground at minimum, or at best, he caught up completely. Okay. What do I mean? The Cleveland Browns, if you look at Baker Mayfield's worst 10 years there, he won six games his rookie year. He won six games his sophomore year. Mm. No Cleveland Browns quarterback had won six games in back-to-back years in the last 20 years since 2001-02 with Tim Couch. At worst, Baker Mayfield made up some ground. Mm. Or at best, no Cleveland Browns quarterback had won a playoff game since 1994. He caught all the way up. So when you want to talk about a success, it was clearly a success because as you look at life, societally, socioeconomic status, our objective isn't to catch all the way up.
Okay.
I went to an elite private school in Dallas, Texas. I've told you about this
a plenty
of times. St. Mark's School of Texas. Bro, I went to school where the owner of the Kansas City Chiefs, he went to school. His kids, they went to school. Mm. Mark Cuban's kids, they went to school. I believe Tony Romo's sons, they go to school.
They got lunch money.
Like, the Acho family is not catching them in one generation.
Okay.
Maybe in several generations, an Acho might catch a Cuban. Yeah. Maybe. An Acho might catch a Hunt. Maybe. But in one generation, that's not going to happen.
I'll be.
But you can make up ground.
Mm.
And so Baker Mayfield, what he did in his tenure was bring the Browns forward. And thus the baton being passed to Deshaun Watson, the Browns are at a much closer position to catching the rest of the league than they would have been otherwise.
Oh, case dismissed over there. I like it. I like it. We went from a relay that was behind, third, fifth place. They were climbing up to slavery. All of this to try and cook these books on Baker Mayfield.
No, we did.
Dog.
From a relay race to slavery.
Four scores and 7 years ago. What the? Dog, you know this was not a success for Baker Mayfield. Let's just build this one slowly. Okay. What were the expectations? I think it's the best way to enter this conversation. Root word of expectation is expect.
Yes, sir.
What did you expect from a number one overall pick? At least for him to get a second contract. Okay, he didn't even get a second contract. Okay, what did we expect from a number one overall pick? At least make us real contenders. He won one playoff game. Okay, so now I'm in a world where my expectations have to adjust because it's Baker Mayfield playing for the Cleveland Browns. You played in the NFL. You went to multiple training camps.
Yes,
and
sir.
I know there was a time where you may have put on the camp goggles. And you know what the camp goggles are. That's when you're up there for 3-4 weeks. I choke. Something in your eye is called the truth. You're up at camp for 3-4 weeks. And all of a sudden, everything that's around you looks a little different just because you went camp. You adjust your expectations.
Am I lying?
Okay. So you go from a world to when your boy's hitting you up, man, how's camp? All good. Oh, I met old girl. I was out. Her name Darlene. Oh, yeah, is she fine? Well, she fine to me. Now, that's a whole different thing because you got them camp goggles on right now. Baker Mayfield, you're a good quarterback. Are you a great quarterback? No, you're great for Cleveland. Okay. And that's the biggest problem you have right now. You made a 2 look like a 10. Mm. You making Baker Mayfield look way better than he does. Here's the thing. The Cleveland Browns, he didn't pass the baton to Deshaun Watson. Deshaun Watson almost had to run backwards. The baton's lying on the ground, pick it up, and now he's trying to make up ground for a Super Bowl-ready roster that had one major issue, lack of leadership and lack of high-level ability at the quarterback position. So now we're looking at this situation where a Jared Goff for the Los Angeles Rams, who takes his team to the Super Bowl, former number one overall pick, does not get a second contract, and we destroy that dude. But then Baker Mayfield, same position, but didn't even take his team to a Super Bowl. We supposed to protect him? Nah, B, I ain't keeping them camp goggles on.
Here's your why, and I love that story. I love that real talk. Josh Allen, Patrick Mahomes, Lamar Jackson, Baker Mayfield. What's Baker doing in a conversation with those cats?
Yeah, that's real.
Woo! Lamar Jackson, 1 playoff win, I believe. Yeah. If I'm not mistaken, 1 playoff win. That's Baker Mayfield, 1 playoff win. Josh Allen, I believe, 2 playoff wins, if I'm not mistaken. Patrick Mahomes, we know what he's done.
Yeah.
Let's talk, America, let's talk. Patrick Mahomes goes to the Chiefs, and clearly he takes the Chiefs to the Super Bowl. But remember, the Chiefs had been to the playoffs 3 of the previous 4 years prior to Patrick Mahomes' arrival. So Kansas City was not that bad of a destination. Josh Allen, he goes to the Buffalo Bills. But remember, the Buffalo Bills were in the playoffs a season prior to Josh Allen's arrival. So the Buffalo Bills was not that bad a destination. Lamar Jackson, unanimous MVP. Lamar Jackson goes to Baltimore. But the Ravens were in the playoffs 3 years prior to Lamar Jackson's arrival. So Baltimore was not that bad a location. But Baker Mayfield. Baker Mayfield shows up. And the Browns, the Cleveland Browns, were 1-31 the 2 prior seasons. As bad as a team can be bad in the history of being bad. Nobody has been that bad in all the days of being bad of badness than 1-31.
Okay.
But somehow, some way, Baker Mayfield takes a team that is as historically bad as has ever been to the playoffs and wins a playoff game. Baker Mayfield wins a playoff game, though the Browns hadn't won one since 94. We have to put this in context, big dog. That's why Baker Mayfield was a success. Yes, you do have to grade the Cleveland Browns on a curve, because as I said this before, the Browns got a whole bunch of bad teachers.
Yeah.
I give more credit to the person that went to the University of Texas along with myself that was succeeding coming from another school, then I do credit from the person that goes to the University of Texas that's succeeding coming from St. Mark's, where I went.
Oh.
I went to a college preparatory school, all boys school. We were in uniform. You got one teacher for every 7 students, not one teacher for every 70 students.
Hey.
So if you go to a good school, I would hope you have good success. If you go to a bad school, I will laud and applaud when you have good success. Baker went to a bad school. Yeah. The worst.
Yeah.
In the projects.
Yeah.
Inner cities.
Yeah.
Gang violence. All the things, big dog. Only had 3 sports. Football, basketball, and track. No lacrosse team. No handball. No wrestling. No swimming. They didn't have a pool. Didn't even have a swimming pool on campus. That's where Baker went. And somehow, some way, still got his team to the playoffs. Success story if I've ever read or heard one.
Wow. Sound like you read my Wikipedia. You're talking about that's everywhere I went. Here we go. Stop playing with me. Baker Mayfield went to a bad school.
Yes, sir.
And wasn't a good student at a bad school. So guess what? No Scully for you. Admissions denied. Get your ass out of here. Oh, we're going to trade him away. This is why. You know this in your heart of hearts. I need to take off that fresh Green Bay Packers suit. Are you going to the Hall of Fame today? The hell are you doing? You look amazing. Here the thing is. Baker Mayfield, be real. After that playoff win, his value may have been $200 to $300 million in terms of talks of an extension. Mm-hmm. Remember, before the 5th-year extension was given to him, talks of Baker Mayfield getting a long-term deal, like Jared Goff did. I actually misspoke. Jared Goff did get that next deal, and then he didn't finish that next deal, even better than Baker Mayfield. And we're in a position right now where Baker Mayfield, within 2 years, a year and a half, went from $300 million conversations to the same team, that bad school, eating $10 million to get rid of you, bad student, because you are ranked 22nd or worse in every major statistical category since you've been in the NFL. Come on. That is just insane for the Cleveland Browns to even sit there and say, we're going to extend our services with you. And even worse, for anyone to categorize this as a success. Remember when Baker Mayfield got there? You're a former Cleveland Brown. You understand this. When LeBron James left Cleveland, who was supposed to fill the sports void of that city? Baker Mayfield. Bigger than life personality, tremendous former number one.
Johnny Manziel. Really, it was Johnny.
Well, oh, yeah, we had Johnny, too, but we knew from Hello. He didn't even have the Baker Mayfield type of success where we could even hang on to. Johnny Manziel was advertised that.
Yes, sir.
Baker Mayfield actually hit the
ground.
Was
supposed to be that. Yep.
Rookie of the year. Rookie of the year. And then all of a sudden the beef comes. You're talking about your coach. He's not your coach anymore. You're still talking about him. Then obviously you get Freddie Kitchens, who probably didn't deserve that job, lost everyone else in that organization their job. You move on. I get it. Four head coaches and four offensive coordinators in 3 years. I hear you. I hear you. I hear you, Baker. Bad teacher, bad teacher. Bad principal, bad dean. But also bad student. Ooh. And that's the toughest thing about it. You got to make me see the greatness in Baker Mayfield for me to deem this a success.
I will. I will. Well, I will. Well. I wasn't the greatest student.
Uh-oh.
I wasn't. I'm going to be honest with y'all.
Were you affirmative action at St. Mark's? Did I just go there? The greatest student.
I had a 2.8 my freshman year, a 3.0 my sophomore year, a 3.2 my junior year, a 3.4 my senior year. I was just steady, Eddie.
All the way.
I recall vividly my senior year when things had started to click. I took a test, and I got a 58. True story. Mm. So it might have been a physics test, I believe. I got a 58. Oh. How? I'm smart at this point in time. I wasn't still dumb. Now I'm smart. I got a 58. So now I got to look around. What the smart kid in the class get? You know, because I was average, right? But the smartest kid in the class, as I looked around, he only got a 78. So I was like, wait a second now, professor. I got a 58, but the smartest kid in the class, it's cum laude, summa cum laude, whatever, he only got a 78. There's a problem. The teacher comes out and says, man, the average on this test was a 55. So you know what we got to do.
What we do?
We got to curve the joint. Because if the average on the test was a 55 and the smartest kid only got a 78, we got to curve it. Because everybody in here can't be stupid. Everybody in here can't be 55s, 58s, 70s, 72s, all the things. Everybody in here can't be stupid.
Everybody can be dumb.
Everybody that's been drafted to the Cleveland Browns can't be bad.
Ooh, look at you.
Robert Griffin, Heisman winner, woes to Cleveland, can't be bad.
Come on, dog. He had one leg.
Fine.
All right.
Colt McCoy.
Come on, dog.
Two-time Heisman finalist. The same Colt McCoy that was in Arizona 10 years later now at 33 years old on the Arizona Cardinals, going 3-1 with the Arizona Cardinals. Yeah. Can't be that bad.
Clipboard completions. Clipboard.
Tim Couch. Couldn't be that bad. Mm-hmm. Brady Quinn. Couldn't be that bad.
Right.
Brandon Weeden at 28 years old, a true veteran going into the NFL because he played baseball first. Couldn't be that bad. Seneca White. Couldn't be that bad. Everybody can't be that bad.
Ooh, I like it.
The fact of the matter is, it's hard to win in Cleveland. I know because I was drafted there. Mm. So my point being, just like you look at the smartest student who gets a 78 on the test and you realize, wait, if the average is a 55, I need to grade on a curve. I'm looking at Baker Mayfield and I dictate his success story and say, I need to grade it on a curve. Because if we pull up one of the full screens, I truly don't care which one y'all pull up. Honestly, you do what you want, Heller. Throw whichever one you want to throw up there. As you look at one of the full screens, Baker Mayfield, when you look at his wins over the course of the first 4 years, or when you look at his average wins per season, it don't matter how you slice it. It don't matter how you dice it. You got to grade him on a curve.
What's that .3 game?
Because while Baker may have only won 7 wins a season.
What?
When I look at the average, Marcellus Wiley, I see 4.
Oh, you going to put Trent on.
Grade that joint on a curve.
I will.
Baker Mayfield is the smartest kid in the class. You see, Emmanuel Acho, I'm like Trent Dilfer. I'm somewhere down there averaging 4. Like, I got some people worse than me, but I definitely ain't the best.
Oh, man.
Meanwhile, Baker Mayfield, he the smartest in the class. He's summa cum laude. Cum laude. He the valedictorian and a salutatorian.
No.
He all of them.
No.
He going to Columbia. He not going to Texas. You
not
feel
with,
me?
Not with no 280, he ain't going
all
to Columbia.
These wins, comparatively, grade him on a curb. It's a success story, big dog.
Grade him on the curb you hit when you try to drive your franchise with Baker Mayfield sitting there as your driver. That's what's going to happen, right into the curb, not grade him on a curb. You have any of your boys that just habitual line steppers in terms of relationships? Mm. They just can't keep a relationship. It's always somebody's fault, and it's never theirs, right? So it's the other person. Ah, man, I met her. Oh, she's amazing. Oh, well-rounded. Every 5 days later, here we go. Then you loop back around 5 months later, here we go. We just go. You got one of those boys. Everyone does, right? You know what I learned about those dudes? Because I used to be one of those dudes, so I have great intel. two things are going wrong. One, they're picking the wrong people because they're the wrong person.
Okay.
Now, in this situation, you can't see straight because you're looking through a clouded lens, which is, I don't know how to value and grade and judge the quarterback position. Let's just use that at Cleveland. Cleveland doesn't know which way is up in terms of the quarterback position. Maybe they got it right finally now for Deshaun Watson. But think what they had to do to get Deshaun Watson. We need a cleanup in aisle six. Baker Mayfield spilled all of this over there. $230 million cleanup to clean up what Baker Mayfield made a mess of. So going back to your boy, he doesn't know how to see what's great because he's not in a great position himself. Cleveland Browns, you're right. They have not made great choices at this position.
Mm-hmm.
But also, you're wrong. They are looking at guys who shouldn't be in that position in the first place. Use Baker Mayfield, former number one overall pick, against the former number one overall pick the year before. Miles Garrett. Was Miles Garrett's career so far, has his career been a success in Cleveland?
Of course.
You see how you closed your eyes? You see how you gave that emphasis? See how the exclamation point just came out your mouth? Then think of Baker Mayfield. You know what Baker Mayfield is when you talk about him in Cleveland and his success? It's complicated. The old Facebook status is complicated. It's a long, long story that's going to end more negative than positive. He won't even end his tenure in Cleveland with the former number one overall pick status. He has to now be traded to Carolina. That's not successful.
Quickly, I have something for you. Myles Garrett's career in Cleveland has been a success, but the reason I wouldn't even say comparatively, it has been as successful as Baker Mayfield is this.
Number one.
In Cleveland, we've seen defensive beasts before.
That's real.
Joe Hayden.
That's real.
I play with me. Dude. Denzel Ward, there right now. Dude. Myles Garrett, there right now. Dude. We've seen linebackers come through, inside backers come through and be dudes. T.J. Ward, safety, beast. Mm. We've seen Cleveland have beasts at defensive end. At running back, I love what Nick Chubb is doing. I love what Kareem Hunt's doing. We've seen Peyton Hillis do it before.
Mm-hmm.
Dudes. We have not seen a Browns quarterback be good in the last 33 years. Yeah, you got to go back to 87, 88. So with that being said, at least you have to admit this.
Okay.
Baker is the best quarterback the Browns have seen since the turn of the century. I don't know if that's arguable.
Well, he's only number one in passer rating, which is major.
Wins.
But other statistical categories, you see him, he's third, fourth franchise history. But I hear you. All things considered, Baker Mayfield seemed like he had the most impact.
All things considered, yeah. Baker Mayfield, if you are the greatest thing that has happened to an organization at a position in the last 33 years, to me, it's successful. Like, I will rest my case on that. Mm. You might not be the greatest thing that's happened to the NFL in the last 33 years, but if you're the greatest thing that's happened to Fox in the last 33 years, how can you say it's not a success? If somebody's the greatest thing that's happened to Marcellus in the last 33 years, how can it not be a success? If you're the greatest thing that's ever happened to something in the last 33 years, to me, big dog, it's got to be a slam.
God, that sounds like a slam dunk, except no. Does it end this way if it's a success? Does it end this way? The movie doesn't end this way when it was successful. Like, you got to have a good ending.
That's a good point.
I mean, and that's the only thing that gives me reservation, which makes me have to have explanation. Because it doesn't end this way if you did all of this. So you use them against other positions. Let's just say there's a big field right here, and there's fertile ground at every position, defensive end, running back, tight, everywhere, except quarterback. I can respect that. It's a dry patch in this field. But then I look in that same division. I don't even want to go league-wide, just your division. Joe Burrow comes on the team, 2-win team, 4-win team, Super Bowl attending team, and that's your division. So maybe it's not your field, but it's right next to you. And that's a number one overall pick going to a horrible organization after you. He getting passed up in that relay example you had earlier on. Sorry, Baker, you needed to make up that ground, but do it now in Carolina.